It's very clear that there is a division happening right now at Fox News. You've got a couple hosts on the network, people like Sean Hannity, who just last week did his little town hall with Donald Trump. But Sean Hannity is an absolute 100% Trump supporter, and he is going to use his program to push Donald Trump onto the public. But then you've got other parts of the network, specifically the folks on that Fox and Friends couch, that have basically turned the page. And a couple days ago, Steve Doocy, of all people, prompted, by the way, by Brian Kil Mead, actually gave Republicans the best reason ever to not vote for Donald Trump in the Republican primary. Here's what happened. Brian Kil Mead brought up the fact that Ron DeSantis is out there basically campaigning and telling people repeatedly, I will serve for 8 years. He keeps saying 8 years, two terms, 8 years, 8 years. And the reason, of course, is because Donald Trump can only serve one more term. You know, until, of course, he shreds the Constitution, pulls his coup, and tries to be installed as a dictator, which I'm not kidding. I do believe that would be a possibility. But technically, legally, Donald Trump can't serve more than 4 more years in office. So DeSantis has that edge of I can have 2 terms, I can be there for the next 8 years. We need 8 years to fix the problem. Trump can only give you 4. That's half of what I can do. And here is what Steve Doocy had to say about that. So on his first day, talking about Trump, he would be a lame duck. And that is one of the considerations big donors have. And the worry from a lot of big donors is not only does Donald Trump win the primary, there's a real good chance he would lose the White House, but also lose the House. And that's one of the problems. So he would be a lame duck on day one. Now, Ducey's not wrong. Weird thing to say, but he's not wrong. And that is a major setback for Donald Trump. So if I am a Republican voter and I'm looking at history, typically, not always, but typically, when you have a president of one party that is not up for re-election, then you go into an election, the opposition party typically retakes the White House. At least that's how it's been throughout most of modern history, with, of course, the exception of from Reagan to H.W. Bush. After that, when a president hit their end of their term and 2 new candidates came up, the opposition party is the one who gained control. So, knowing that, if Donald Trump goes and serves his final term, he would not be the nominee in 2028. So you would have 2 new people up there, a new Democrat, new Republican. And coming off 4 years of what's probably going to be pretty damn terrible, the Democrat is definitely going to win. I'm not even going to say probably, I'm going to say definitely going to win that point. But with Ron DeSantis, who knows, right? He may be able to pull it off. He may be able to be a two-termer. We may not have another Democrat in that White House till the year 2033, when they would be inaugurated on January 20th of 2033. That's 10 years from now, folks. Think about that for a minute. So if I'm a Republican voter and I'm looking at what these two men have to offer me, knowing that Trump would be a one and done, but DeSantis could be 2, I'd like to go with the longevity. Do you want to buy a product that's going to definitely crap out after 4 years? Or do you want to buy a product that could last you up to 8? I mean, that seems like a pretty easy sell. Of course, the 8-year product that you're selling is Ron DeSantis, which is basically a piece of crap in a cardboard box. So not exactly a great product, but the sales pitch is a hell of a lot better with DeSantis. Now, again, I'm not saying any of this. I'm just saying strategically, that is what DeSantis' team needs to do, because that might be a good way to hit at Donald Trump. Now, in practice, I hate DeSantis probably more than I hate Donald Trump. I think Donald Trump is the most beatable Republican, so I would love to see him be the nominee as opposed to DeSantis. Now, if that changes, if the polls change, then I will amend my statement. But as of right now, that's basically what we're dealing with. But DeSantis does have ways to hit at Trump. He just doesn't have the best team around him to tell him how to do it.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.